Hello guys, how are you? I hope all of you are fine. And so today, I hope I'm missing you people. I don't know whether you people are missing us or not. But we have really limited time to cover the syllabus, so let us move to the point directly. Okay. So our today's topic is snapshot. Okay. Chapter 4. Albert Einstein at school. This is our today's chapter. Okay, and it has been written by Patrick Pringle. The author name is Patrick Pringle. Okay, so who was Patrick Pringle? Actually, he was a photographer, writer, and biologist. And he won many awards. He was the chief of a technical institute as well. Okay. And he won many awards as well. In 1970 also he won an award. He was born in 1935. Okay, so actually this is a part, this is all about the great scientist Albert Einstein. You might have heard about Albert Einstein. Okay, so Albert Einstein, you know, most of you people are thinking that Albert Einstein, he was a great scientist and he was very intelligent in his school time. But here, this chapter is telling you that what happened with Einstein in school time. Means, did he like school really? And I hope this is quite most interesting topic for you people. That most of you don't like school and now, but I think you are missing schools because you are sitting at home and you don't have anything to do. Okay, and now I think you are getting to know what is the importance of school and what is the importance of teachers. Okay, so Albert Einstein, he was really not happy to go to school. In fact, he was feeling that school was the most boring place in the world. Okay. First of all, Albert Einstein, he was an introvert kind of personality. In classes also, I have told you what is introvert and what is extrovert and what is ambivert. But let me explain it again. Okay, introvert kind of personality means who think that the whole world is only me. That I myself is a whole world. He does not talk to anybody else except few. Okay. Except few, they have only few people, they want only few people around them and they just talk to them only. They don't like gatherings and all. Okay, second one is extrovert. The people who find their happiness in the gatherings, the people who always, they want company, they can't live alone. They are extrovert kind of people. And the third one is ambivert. Okay, ambivert, most of people are ambivert. Okay, and who are these ambivert? Actually, if you have a company of somebody, you enjoy it. And if you don't have them, okay, fine, we are alone. So, this is an attitude of an ambivert kind of person. Okay, so, he was an introvert kind of person and he did not like school at all, I'm telling you. He was feeling that the school was the boring thing, boring place of the whole world. Okay, no other boring place could be found according to him. So, here in our chapter, first of all, I'm telling you that this is not the complete biography, okay. This chapter is an extract of Einstein's biography, okay. And this person has written his biography and this chapter has been taken from that biography. This is only an extract and this extract is focusing on specially his school time, Albert Einstein's school time, okay. So, who are the main characters here in our chapter? Let us have a look on those characters. First is Einstein himself, okay. Second is Yuri. Yuri was the only friend. Okay, as I told you, he was an introvert kind of person. So he had only one friend and he was Yuri. Okay, second one is Elsa. Elsa, she was his cousin. Elsa was his cousin. And the fourth character is Dr. Ernest Will. Dr. Ernest Will. He is the person who gave him the medical certificate of nervous breakdown. Okay. And now let me tell you the summary of this chapter. And the summary of this chapter, actually it starts from his school days when Albert Einstein was sent to the school. Okay, he was sent to Munich for schooling, for his schooling, but he was for getting a diploma. He was sent to Munich, but actually he was not feeling good at all that. He found the school the most boring place of the world, and he wanted to get rid of the place. And you know, for the same, he was behaving in a rebellious way in the class. While he was in the class, the teachers, they could not able to continue their lessons, and especially it happened in history and geology. Okay, he was not liking all these subjects at all. Only one subject he liked, and that was maths. Okay, when the things were out of control, when the things were out of means his bearing level, then Einstein thought that I should get a medical certificate from a doctor, and I think I should leave because I cannot live here anymore. Okay, and second thing, that his parents were poor, so the accommodation facility was given to him. Whatever the accommodation facility was given, means the residential facility was given to him, that was also not up to the mark. He was living somewhere in a slum, and he was very upset with the slum violence. Here in the chapter, he is narrating the whole scene of his landlord and landlady. Okay, and while we'll read the chapter, will see this. Okay, and he was not happy at all, neither from school not from the residential place. So he planned that he talked to Yuri that, Yuri, you do one thing, you just if you have, Yuri was a medical student, so of course he had some contacts with the medical that doctors, that if you can find out some doctor who can give me a certificate for nervous breakdown, then I can get out of school, and 6 months medical certificate will be enough for me, and I'll get my diploma, and you know, it will be good for me as well as for the school, because for school, for the teachers, it was a headache. Okay, and the teachers, the schools, Einstein, nobody liked at all to be together. Okay, so Yuri managed at all, and when he went to the doctor, then the doctor really found that Einstein had a nervous breakdown, and if he would be in the same environment for a long time, then it would be very harmful for his health. That's why he gave him a medical certificate, and he prescribed him, he asked him to suggested him to take some rest for at least for 6 months. But before presenting that medical certificate to principal's office, the principal office, the head teacher himself called him, and he just asked him to leave the school. Means finally, Mr. Albert Einstein was expelled from the school. Okay, and later you know what happened with Albert Einstein, how great scientist he was. So here, you know, what is the purpose of including this special extract in your syllabus? Do you know the special purpose of including this extract in your syllabus is to tell you that this doesn't matter if you right now, if you are feeling that the academics is out of your reach, then don't get demotivated. Okay, you can't say that what kind of talent you have. You know, Einstein, he was very poor in all the subjects except maths, and that one subject, you know, just make him to reach somewhere, and you know, goal where he was. Okay. So please don't feel inferior if you are in particular subject, in any of the particular subject, you may find yourself less than others. But believe me, somewhere you are more than those others. So I hope, children, you have got the point what the writer wants to tell you. Okay, and we'll read the chapter, and while we'll read the chapter, you'll get this point. And you'll get this point properly, and surely you will understand that each and every individual is special. Okay, and with this beautiful thought, today's lecture is over, and we'll meet tomorrow. Okay, and I hope you people will do well, and today you are going to read this chapter out before our next class. In next class, we'll move to the text. And before moving to the text, I want you people to read out the text, read out the summary, so that you can connect it to me in a proper way. Okay? And the difficult words can be understood, can be understood very well. Okay? And with it, have a nice day. Goodbye.